Okay, students, in this first video here, which will probably be one of just a couple here, I want to do a little review of Gravy with you. And as I do this, I'm going to take a fun little jab at astrology. And so we'll do all that together and even show you some of the numbers that have to do with the law of gravity, just to do a little bit of calculation in our Astronomy 101 class here. Okay, so the law of gravity, as we know it thus far with the orbits and the simulations and things that I've showed you, is that the force of gravity has to do with two masses, mass 1 and mass 2, and a distance between them. And so the trends in the law that you see here maybe are kind of clear to you here. In particular, Fg is proportional to M1 and M2. And proportional is sort of a big deal here because what it says is that you'll get some force of gravity proportional to M1 and M2. That means the larger M1 becomes, the larger gravity becomes. Like if you double the mass of one of the objects, gravity will double. And M2 is also up here too. Like if I make M2 10 times as large, the force of gravity will become 10 times as large because they're exactly proportional to one another. The other aspect of the law here is that Fg is inversely proportional to d, but not just d, but d squared. That's important. There is it squared right here. Inversely proportional to d squared. And so what that means for you here in terms of gravity is that the larger distance that objects get between them, the smaller gravity becomes, okay? So as d sort of goes up, f sub g goes down. And as d goes down, like if you somehow made the objects get closer together, the force of gravity then would go up. Okay, so that's definitely what inversely proportional means. Where in the case over here that we just did with the proportional, we would say something like if m1 went up, then fg would go up in kind. Likewise, if m2, say, went down, F sub g would go down too, and any other combination of these you can find in there will also work. Okay, so that's sort of what we're doing. Now, this squared often can confuse students because the squared is not a straight proportionality. So for example here, the way the square works here is I would say like if d sort of went up by 2, in other words, you doubled the distance. You double the distance between two objects. So if object 1 was here and object 2 is here, and suppose they were like, you know, 1 million miles apart, if they were here and here and you drew a line between them and you made them 2 million miles apart, the question is, what would happen to F sub G? Well, you might think, well, it looks like the distance is doubling, and we said that F sub G is inversely proportional to the distance, so I guess that would mean that F sub G would then go down by 2. In other words, F sub G would be halved. Okay? You're doubling the distance, so F sub G would be halved. That's what inverse proportional means. But this is not right. This is not what we sort of said about gravity, so this would not be right. F sub G would not be halved for the sole reason because it's 1 over distance squared. Remember, F sub g here is sort of proportional to 1 over d squared. So what would happen in a case like this then is if the distance went up by 2, so distance was doubled, the force of gravity is 1 over d squared. The force of gravity would go down not by 2, but by 4. And the reason it's by 4 is because 2 squared is equal to 4. This is a very important ramification of the law of gravity here. The squared law dictates what some of these trends would be. And you can do all kinds of cases like this here. If the distance was increased by 4, say you quadruple the distance between two objects, well, the force of gravity would go down by a factor of 16, in fact, because 4 squared is equal to 16. So this is a very important aspect of the law of gravity, and collectively it's known as an inverse squared law in astronomy. And there's a lot of inverse squared laws in physics. For instance, the loudness of a sound is inverse squared. So if you hear like a big boom going off, if you've moved twice as far away from the boom, the loudness would be a fourth that it was if you were closer to it. That kind of thing, these inverse squared laws are important. Okay? And one last little puzzle piece that we'll put together with this here. We have to complete the law of gravity before we head on to any numerics here. So you have the relatively simple proportionality of the masses. You have the slightly more complex inverse d squared dependence, which we discussed. Move a factor of 2, it goes down by 4, that kind of thing. What we have to do to make it into a complete equation then is to get rid of this approximate sign here and put an equal sign in there. But before we do that, or in order to do that, we have to put a capital G in here. And what G is, this is called the gravitational constant. And in physics, it's just something you have to know, but you're not going to memorize it for this class. But it'll be 6.67 times 10 to the minus 31. So it's a very small number. In fact, it's a 6.67 with 30 zeros in front of it. It's a 0.123 all the way 30 zeros all the way down like that. Then you get a 31. That's what the gravitational constant would be. But the reason why we have to put that in now is because now we have a full, complete, computable law of gravity. F is equal to g m1 times m2 over distance squared, and we're now free to plug numbers into this because we know what g is now. We can choose some masses and some distances and things and come up with an actual number for gravity, and that's what I'll use in the next video to take my jab at astrology.